I just made my first mistake. Just walked all the way in. And the whole time, I know I hit record when I first got out of my truck and come through the gate. And I get back here and I look and my phone is not recording. It's back on picture or camera or whatever you want to call it. So I'm starting over again. But anyway, of course, right? I just had a bunch of noise right around the center of my screen. I don't know. I have to go back and look. But I had either a tree break or even, you know, I'm not saying 100%, but I either had a tree break or a big limb fall out of the top of a tree over on this hill. On that hill right there. And then I heard walking, like someone was walking that hillside. And what that does, let's go back a little bit, right in there, it goes up. It starts to go up. I don't know if you can tell by in the video, but it does go uphill. You can see there's the field edge up there. That's part of my property. It goes up and goes back to the left. And then of course back around this way. But yeah, I didn't know it. My phone wasn't on record. That sucks. I'm learning. I'm definitely new to this. I've gained a whole new respect for everyone. Here we go again. What in the heck is that noise? It's almost like something. Every time I move, it moves, but it's moving faster. And then as soon as I just said something, when I said, what the heck, it stopped. There is something over on this edge where I'm pointing. But I can't get an exact pinpoint on where I'm hearing it. I know it's somewhere on this hill, straight in front of me. See what I like about this. Straight back where I've got the camera pointed right now, the power lines run through the back of my property. And of course I used to hunt that back, you know, some years ago. But that's where things feel the strangest at. Between here and the meadow where I've shot the last two videos of the meadow by the creek. There's something, I've heard it three times now over here, and I don't know what it is. I heard that. Did you guys hear that? That sounded like rock. Two stones hitting together. Let me see if I can get around here a little bit. I don't smell that smell anymore. I had a terrible smell when I was first coming in. And then once I got back here, I got another whiff of it. I was just standing still. And it smelled like a wet dog. A combination of a wet dog and like rotten fish. Again. What in the hell is that on that hillside? I know you guys gotta be here. That's like the fourth time. I know you guys at least heard it once. I'll tell you what. it's a little strange feeling here. I feel something. I feel like I'm definitely being watched. I don't mind it, but it's a little bit stronger today than it normally is. I'm trying to see what's up on that hill. There's dark, something dark up there looking straight down at me. Let me see if I can get around here a little bit, see if I can look at it. Right up there. It's like something right there. And then I see something else. I don't see it. Hold on. Wait a minute. Right here. I've got all kinds of noise around me right now. I don't know what it is. Ooh, what's this? What is this? Hold on, guys. What is this? Show you guys without it going down there, right there, the black spot. It almost looks like it's got two eyes, but when I look over the over top the camera, I don't see those two spot light spots. I just see the dark spot. Here I am again, stuck in one spot. I need to move. I want to get back here further. Alright, bear with me. I don't like walking under and over these logs because of the snakes. The copperheads are bad through here. Really dark back here, except for what I'm videoing right now. But when I come back around, it starts to get. It's just. The sun's starting to peek down more and more, and it starts to get really dark in here. Inside the woods, anyway. Ooh, there it is again. When I put this video up, guys, let me know if you heard that noise. That's five times I've heard that over there where I'm videoing right now, where I've got the camera pointed. It's, of course, it's down further. There's like a black clump right there in the center, like a stump laid over. That's where I just heard it again, this time. So it's moved down about 60 yards or so, 40, 60 yards. But I can't really tell what it is. Bear with me, guys. I got something over here. Let me see. Straight back in the center of my screen, and there's a dark spot back there. There's something right there. Right underneath that green bush, there's something light color there. I keep looking behind me. I feel like somebody's standing behind me. It's weird. I haven't had these feelings back here but a couple of times in 25 years. there's something definitely walking, and I cannot figure out where it's coming from. But whatever it is, it's heavy stuff. And of course, if you guys see something, please post it in the comments. Let me know. Like I said, right now I'm still hearing footsteps. It's almost like wet, like a squish, squish, squish. Which tells me it's further back where I'm pointing the camera right now. It's all like meadow back there, straight back. I don't know, guys. I'm gonna try to move around some more. Let me see if I can get this zoomed out a little bit. There we go. Strange. They got like a blind over here. I'll get it to where I can show you here. Right there. Remember that stump, that dark area back in the summer I was back here. Look at those trees back here, those logs leaning against the tree right there, kind of teepee type. I know one thing, I gotta get my eyes checked out. Man, my eyes are blurry today. Having a hard time seeing it. That looks like a camera on my tree. I can't tell. Let me see if I can get this thing back out. I'm learning. I found a few things back here. I found a structure back here about a month ago. And of course, I wasn't videoing or really taking any pictures then. I didn't really think about it at the time. I want to go back here and see if it's still here. I don't want to go back too far because it's starting to get dark. I mean, it's not dark, but it gets dark quick here because we're down in the bottom. Ooh, there's that smell again. What the hell? See now, straight back, that's all, that's that meadow, it runs clean back into those woods for about, I'd say, 10 acres or so, and then it opens up to the power lines that I was talking about earlier. Now, I know this. What in the hell was that? Sorry, guys, I had the camera all the way zoomed in. I definitely want to show you this real quick though. Look at the base of this tree.
Now that's beaver to me. That's wild. I was saying in the last video that I've never heard my grandfather or anybody, my dad, talk about beavers here. So that may answer some questions over on that creek edge that I've had been wondering about. Now see this limb right here? It's a tree with a limb on top, but I don't know where that limb, I'm trying to figure out where that limb come from. It's right on top, right there. You can see that hill over there a little bit better now. See how it goes up? That's where I was hearing all that noise when I first come in here. I'm too far down to be able to look up in that direction again. I was seeing something up on that hill, and that's where I had that face, that huge head in that briar wall, briar patch, sticky bush, whatever you want to call it. I call them bullbriars. Now, when I first walked in here, I personally felt like I was hearing anything from rock clacks to a tree being pushed over, or like I said, even possibly a limb falling out of the top of a tree, or I don't know, it was loud, and it wasn't that far from me. It was over here on this hill. But then as time went on, I heard the walking from right about where the center of my screen is. It worked its way all the way around to about right about in there. And that's where I heard like the footsteps were like sloshing in water. It was like sloosh, 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 sloosh. And just the way I heard it, it sounded like it was heading around like this.
I mean, no disrespect, guys. Just passing through. I think Saturday I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna gift. I'm gonna bring back some apples, and I got a mess of pears that a farmer down the road from me, he gave me a couple bushel of pears. And some, I got some turnips. I think I'm gonna bring them back here Saturday morning and gift them. Usually when I fish here, I'll catch a mess of the smaller fish, the bluegill, sunfish, you know, pumpkin seeds. I'll catch 8 or 10, 12 dozen of them, you know, and I'll put them in a pile back here on the pass, back where I first come in at. And I've purposely done it and come back the next day early. I've actually done it in the morning and come back that same day in the evening, and they were gone. And if you go back into my pictures on my page, actually, I think it's on my main, it's one of my main pictures on my channel. That triangle was left where the pile of fish I left. It was left there and the fish were gone. So I don't know if that's like one of their ways of saying thank you or what, but I do know for a fact that that triangle wasn't there when I put the fish down. And pretty much since then, every time I fish, I make it a point to take time out, catch them some fish and leave them. On that hill, whatever it is, it's either clumsy or it just doesn't care. I mean, it is something's traveling that hill. I'm gonna head back out. I just had the weirdest thought. Something told me to just go ahead and turn around. That's enough. Go ahead and go back where you come from. I'm not exaggerating. That's how I feel right now. That's what it was. It was a voice. I just heard a voice in my head and said, okay, enough. Turn around now. Figure out how. I wanted to turn my phone around. I don't like just talking to the back of the screen. And I also don't like sitting here with my back to the back of the woods either. I'm uneasy today. This is. Never like this. I don't ever feel like this. I'm usually in this bad of a vibe. I'm gonna head back out front. Maybe by the next video, I'll be able to get back further. I don't know. Look at that. It's just leaning against the tree. That's odd. And it's been broken. It's not something that was cut or. And didn't come off of this tree, because that's a whole different type of tree. Oh, yeah, I'm walking back out front. I just don't feel right. It's a strange feeling. Now that's fresh. That wasn't down. I'm gonna have to look at my last video. You can see how fresh that is. I don't remember that cherry tree being broke right there and down across there. It actually looks like it pushed this tree. Let me zoom back out. It actually hit that tree and went and pushed it over into that other. Actually uprooted it all. Yeah, it's a couple of them. Yeah, this one here. I don't remember them being like that. I'll have to go back and look. I'll cut that up for firewood next year, I guess. I don't know. That's another thing I used to do back here. I used to cut the fallen trees, the rotted, you know, rotted trees. I'd cut them up for firewood and give them to the family members, give the wood to family members. Now I don't even like doing it. I feel like I shouldn't be, to be honest with you. I don't know. Kind of like, I know it sounds strange, it's my property, but I don't know. I just feel like I shouldn't be doing it. Something right there. I don't know what that is. Sorry for the camera all over the place. It's got me edgy back here this evening. I don't know what it is. It's a whole different feel back here today, this evening. I'm not digging it, I can tell you that. I'm not vibing it. And I never feel like this. I get my normal feelings, you know. I can tell things, something staring at me, or especially over here. But this evening's a whole different thing. Hit this one more time, and then I'm gonna ease my way back out of here. I might get back up to the head of the creek and drop a line in the water for a minute. I don't know. I might just get out of here altogether. I think that's maybe what I should do. Now I hear that. Something's walking again. I don't know where that's coming from, because it's hard to hear with this water running. All right. I think I've worn my welcome out. Get up out of here. Get back out front. Oh, man. It's beautiful back here, though. The water is way up right now. Can't believe I haven't stirred up any snakes along this edge. Let me see if I can get another shot here. I wanted to say also, you guys get a chance. If you haven't already, I'm sure you have. Mostly everybody that's in, that follows this field, and, you know, that likes watching this subject, I'm sure they already know about him. But going over to Long Island Bigfoot, LIB, he's 100% truth. He's a good guy. He knows what he's talking about. I know I said it in the last video, but if you haven't already gone over and subscribed, do so. Check him out and subscribe and like and share his channel. He's really awesome. Like I said, he knows what he's doing. He's been out in the field for He's been out here for some time, a very good while. He's had boots on the ground for a very long time, and he doesn't, he's not in it for the clout. Let's put it like that. And, I've learned 99% of what I know from him. 98, 99. I mean, willing to go 100 because I knew nothing other than I had a sighting. And I got watching LIB's channel and Long Island Bigfoot's channel and started learning that pretty much I could pay attention to him and listen to what he's got to say. And I learned so much from that. I'm so glad that I took the time to do it, and I'm thankful that he was taking the time out of his day and his family to come out and investigate the way he does. He puts a lot of time out here, or out into the field. So he's definitely one that you need to check out, if you, like I said, if you haven't already. It's Long Island Bigfoot. He's up in New York, obviously. All right, guys, I think that's going to be it. I think I've worn my welcome out here. Like I said, Saturday morning, I'm going to come out and gift, come back here and gift. And I'll post something Friday, give an exact time when I'm going to do the gifting. And I'll give you guys a heads up about Saturday morning. I appreciate you checking me out. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe, like, and share. I really appreciate it. I'm new to a YouTube channel. I just started. And I appreciate everyone that checks me out. You guys have a good evening. Thanks again.